Hi, I'm Cindy Jones. We're going to talk about preserving cosmetics today. I'll tell you a little bit about myself. I have a PhD in biochemistry, as well as degrees in toxicology, microbiology, and chemistry. I've always loved science and studied it in school. Science is the study of nature, and so it was natural that I would also be interested in herbalism. So I'm a self-taught herbalist. I've taught college classes in microbiology, anatomy, and physiology, as well as a few other classes. I did basic research in cancer for a few years before I started medical writing. I started to make DIY skincare products at some time just as a reason to use some of the herbs that were growing in my garden. And I started loving doing it. So I did it more and more. I started Sage Script Institute in 2004. At that time, I was on a number of Yahoo lists with other skincare makers. And I found that there was a need for home crafters to find cosmetic testing services. And so I set up my lab to do micro testing for home crafters. Besides doing micro testing, I do consulting, formulating, and small scale manufacturing for the small maker. And then I have my own skincare line called Colorado Aromatics that I started in 27. At that same time, my husband and I bought a farm. So we grow a lot of herbs and I distill those herbs as well as making herbal extracts. So in this presentation, these are the things that we'll go over. Why do you need a preservative in your product? We'll talk a little bit about a background to understand microbes. Being a basic scientist, I always find it's important to understand the background. We'll talk about how microbes actually get in your cosmetic products, how to control that microbial growth, how microbial testing is done, and what the results look like. Different preservatives have different requirements. We'll talk about what those requirements are. We'll talk about tonicity and what that has to do with preserving products, hurdle technology, and finally, how to choose a preservative for your product. So what exactly is a preservative? Wikipedia defines it here. Preservatives have been very common in food products and much more widely studied in food products. Preservative is a substance or a chemical that is added to products such as food, beverages, pharmaceuticals, paints. It's used across a wide number of industries. And we shouldn't be alarmed at the word chemical. A lot of people get scared at that. A chemical is any liquid, solid, or gas matter. It actually refers to everything. Everything is a chemical. Even the oils that you use in your product are chemicals. They're fatty acids such as oleic acid. Sometimes we use different words like compound or component, but they all mean the same thing. They're all chemicals. So why should you use a preservative in your product? As a maker, you are responsible for the safety of your cosmetic products. You don't want your customers to be rubbing potentially harmful microorganisms over their skin. So you want to make sure that there's preservatives in there that can control any microbial growth. These microbes can be secreting different components that can have an undesirable effect on the product as well, undesirable smell, aroma, color. It's an important part of your good manufacturing practices to use a cosmetic, to use a cosmetic preservative. I've even seen where some wholesale accounts will ask you for a microbiology testing and ask you about preservatives as well. So that brings us to what are a safe cosmetics? There's a lot of opinions out there about what makes a safe cosmetic. And you'll read a lot of blogs that talk about 15,000 chemicals that are banned in the EU that aren't banned in the United States. A lot of this has started just from one blog, copy and paste another blog, and you read it in 100 places just because it's copy and pasted, but that doesn't make it true. Many ingredients that are banned in the EU are ingredients that would never ever be used in a cosmetic product such as jet fuel, gasoline. We just don't use those. So I guess in the United States, they they don't officially ban those because they give makers more credit for not using those. But how do you find out about what safe ingredients are? First, you want to get information from your ingredient suppliers. So every supplier should have information on what the product, what the ingredient is, what it's made from, and how to use it. You can look up the actual science behind it at the National Library of Medicine and see what kind of research has been done on that ingredient. There's also, it used to be a separate website, ToxNet, but now it's actually part of the National Library of Medicine, where you can look up toxicology studies on different ingredients. And then there's the Cosmetic Ingredient Review Panel that looks at different ingredients and publishes monographs on their safety. An important part of safe cosmetics is making sure that the product does not have bacteria and fungus in it. The FDA calls this filth. So the FDA says a product should be free from filth. And we typically interpret filth as meaning bacteria and fungus that are in the product. It also says that a cosmetic should not be misbranded. So we should know what is in that product.